Thank you for taking the time to watch the GSI 39 tutorial. The GSI 39 is a multifunctional screening instrument that offers tympanometry, reflex screening, and pure tone audiometry. It is available in 5 versions to meet the screening needs of many facilities. The GSI 39 comes standard with a 226 Hz probe tone, and a combination probe is available with 1000 Hz for infant screening. When you purchase a GSI 39, you will select the version that is most appropriate for your patient population. This includes selection of the probe tone, 226 Hz only, or the combination of 226 Hz and 1000 Hz probe tones, which results in a different style probe provided. If your patient population does not include infants under the age of 1 year, then the 226 Hz probe tone will be sufficient. The GSI 39 with audiometry includes over-the-ear headphones. Optional accessories include insert earphones and a patient response button. Additionally, the GSI 39 has an onboard printer and is compatible with GSI Suite for electronic management of screening data. This lightweight desktop instrument can easily be moved from facility to facility using the optional carrying case. Before testing a patient, ensure that all transducers that will be used for testing are plugged securely into the back of the instrument. For the audiometry module, ensure that the right earphone is plugged completely into the jack labeled R and the left headphone is plugged completely into the jack labeled L. If there is a contralateral reflex earphone or an optional patient response switch, make sure that they are also plugged completely into the appropriate ports on the back panel of the instrument. After the cables are checked, power on the instrument. If you will be using the onboard printer, load the paper. Observe the tympanometry probe to check for a blinking green light, which indicates that it is ready for testing. The GSI 39 will look the same no matter which version is purchased. Every version will have the same button layout, but depending on which test types are active with the version you purchase, some of the buttons may not be functional. It is possible to upgrade to a different version at any time. To select a test, choose from the 3 test type buttons. Tymp will load the protocol for tympanometry testing only. Tymp/reflex will load the protocol for tympanometry and reflex testing, and AUD will load the protocol for audiometric testing. There are 2 probe types for tympanometry. The 226 Hz probe is the standard probe and resembles a pencil. A combination probe with a shoulder mount will be provided for a version that includes 1000 Hz probe tone. Instead of seating the probe tip deep in the ear canal to obtain a seal, the probe tip should be held at the entrance of the ear canal to achieve the seal. There are indicator lights on the probes that will assist in proper placement and give details about the test. If the light is blinking green, the GSI 39 is ready to begin a test. If the green light is solid, the test is successfully started and in progress. If the orange light is illuminated, a pressure leak has been detected. If the light is a solid yellow, the probe is obstructed and should be removed, inspected for debris, and reseated at the entrance of the ear canal. If there are no lights, the test is complete. The GSI 39 has optimized pressure range and sweep speed for fast and accurate measurements. The pressure range is from positive 200 to negative 400 decapascals. Normative data will be displayed on the screen of the instrument. For 226 Hz tympanometry, the tymp will automatically pressurize and start the test when a seal is obtained. The pressure sweep will stop when the tympanogram returns to the baseline after negative 100 decapascals. Before performing the tympanometry, it is recommended that you inform the patient what to expect from the evaluation. Explain that you are going to evaluate the way their eardrum moves. They will hear a low tone, feel pressure in the ear canal, and they do not need to respond in any way. The test will only take a couple of seconds, and all they have to do is sit quietly. If you are testing reflexes, let the patient know that in addition to the low tone, there will be some brief beeps. They do not need to respond to the beeps, but just sit quietly until the evaluation is complete. Examine the ear canal to determine the appropriately sized ear tip and place it on the end of the GSI 39 probe. Make sure that the ear tip is pushed all the way down to the casing of the probe. To perform only tympanometry, select the Temp button. Follow your facility's guidelines for screening procedures. To test tympanometry and reflexes, select the Temp/Reflex button. The default test is tympanometry with the ipsilateral reflex at 1000 Hz. To test additional frequencies, select the desired stimulus frequencies using the buttons. Selections are displayed on the LED screen. To perform the test, hold the 226 Hz probe tone securely at the entrance of the ear canal to create an airtight seal. If your device has the combo probe, place the shoulder mount with the probe box on the shoulder near the test ear. Place an ear tip onto the end of the probe and insert it into the ear canal. When a seal is obtained, the GSI 39 will automatically begin testing. The lights on the probe will inform you of the status of the test. When the light is solid green, the test is being performed. When the light goes off, that means the test is complete and the probe may be removed from the ear. To test pure tone air conduction audiometry, press the AUD button in the middle of the front panel. There are 12 buttons in the middle of the instrument that will be used in the audiometry module. The buttons in the blue work area are to set up the signal and transducers for testing. Available signal modifications are as follows: steady tone, which is indicated by the button with a solid line, pulse tone, which is indicated by the button with the dashed line, and warble tone, which is indicated by the FM or frequency modulation button. The selected tone modification will be indicated on the LED screen of the GSI 39. The button with the picture of the insert phone will activate the insert earphone calibration, while the button with the picture of the headphones will activate the headphone calibration. Verify the image of the selected transducer that appears on the LED screen matches the transducers that are connected to the unit. The left and right arrow buttons change the frequencies. The M+ button saves the response, and the +10 button extends the decibel output by 10 for testing patients with severe hearing loss or those who do not respond at the maximum output levels. The ear selection will be made by pressing the L button for the left ear and the R button for the right ear. The knob will adjust the presentation level, and the presentation bar will activate the pure tone stimulus when pressed. Before placing the transducers, it is recommended that you inform the patient what to expect from the evaluation. Explain that you're going to place headphones over their ears, and then they will hear a series of beeps or tones. Instruct the patient to respond to the tones even if they are soft or far away by either raising their hand or pressing the patient response switch. When the patient is comfortable with the process, place the headphones over the patient's ear, making sure the headphones are centered over the ear. Make sure the headphone labeled R is over the right ear and the headphone labeled L is over the left ear. The distance between the headband and the earphones can be adjusted up or down depending on the patient. When the transducers are properly placed, testing can begin. For insert phones, examine the ear canal for obstruction or excessive cerumen. Place the tube of the foam ear tip completely onto the sound tube for each earphone. Roll the foam tip in the smallest diameter possible and insert the ear tip well into the ear canal with the red earphone in the right ear and the blue in the left ear. Select the test frequency using the right and left arrow buttons on the front panel of the GSI 39. Select the decibel level with the attenuation knob. Present the tone by pressing the presentation bar on the front panel. Follow the screening guidelines of your facility to complete the evaluation. This may be one presentation at a single level for each frequency, or a threshold evaluation at a number of frequencies. Regardless of the protocol, you will record the results by pressing the M+ button when each frequency is complete. Up to 12 completed tests are automatically stored in the memory of the GSI 39. You can access and manage saved tests by entering the page mode. To do this, press the page mode button. To scroll through the saved tests, use the arrows in the odd section of the front panel. From page mode, you can review, print, transfer, or delete stored tests. To exit page mode, press the page mode button again. To print the current test results with the onboard printer, select the printer button. To print every test stored in memory, press the print all button. It is also possible to transfer the data to GSI Suite for electronic data management. Open GSI Suite and select the Tympanometry tab. Then press the data transfer button on the GSI 39. When the data is printed or transferred, it is important to clear the memory of the GSI 39 to avoid mixing up patient results. To erase a single test, press the M- button. To erase all tests from the memory, press the M- button. It is possible to customize the GSI 39 default settings from the program mode. To enter program mode, press the PROG button on the front panel of the instrument. When program mode is entered, there will be a list of customizable parameters for the GSI 39, including the probe, tympanometry, reflex display, printing, and more. Use the left and right arrow keys and the attenuator knob to move through the list of options on the screen. The page button is used to enter the submenu of an option. The M+ toggles an option on or off. An asterisk appears to the left of the item to denote the item has been selected. Pressing the M+ again removes the asterisk, which deselects an item. The word Save should appear on the lower right corner of the LCD screen after the M+ button has been selected. The parameters selected in the program mode will load when a test type button is pressed. Some parameters can be changed during testing by simply selecting other buttons on the front panel of the instrument. The GSI 39 is not designated as a sterile device. Non-disposable parts of the system, including headphone cushions and the probe, which are in direct contact with the patient, need to be disinfected between patients. This includes physically wiping down the parts that come into contact by using a disinfectant approved by your facility. Use of a non-alcohol-based disinfectant is recommended. Non-alcohol-based products which contain the active ingredient referred to as quaternary ammonia compound or a hydrogen peroxide-based cleaner may be used. Both disinfectants are specifically designed to disinfect rubber, plastic, silicone, and acrylic products which are commonly used in hearing evaluation instruments. This concludes the GSI 39 tutorial. If additional questions arise, please consult the user manual, contact your local distributor, or contact GSI.